My team consists of Ayushi Rastogi from NIT Jamshedpur and myself, Anishvi Monsi from IIT Guwahati. We are in charge of the course definition, course creation, and instantiation module in the TQ website. A brief introduction. As Avinash sir had already pointed out, it's basically if a movie is being shown in a theater and it's shown multiple times, we need to create a definition for the movie. Similarly, a course template is created only once and then instances are created of it. So for this purpose, we are having this module. So initially, we create or manage pilot FDPs. So this is the form. We are just showing presentations for the moment. So the new feature in this is, earlier in the old NMEICT site, there were many redundant fields. So to prevent all that, we have an add custom field. So this add custom field allows a wide variety of fields to be added for any particular workshop. So then these are the same old fields as the NMEICT site. We are not going through these. And also a course key in IIT Bombay X. This is very important because this will uniquely define the course in IIT Bombay X when later shipped. Basically, when the template is created, later on, the same template will go to the IIT Bombay X sandbox server. After that, content will be defined and then moved, exported to the main production server. So for this purpose, these fields are required. So after defining these, we can submit the form. And then after creating the FDP, we need to define its grading policy. So we choose the FDP. We define the grading policy, category weightages, then assessment types. Similar to template, again define the assessment type and instantiate them. You can delete them. And also this is for the face-to-face. So after you submit this, this is where a new feature comes in. We automatically insert the course into the sandbox server. For this, we created a course creation API. So now Ayushi will take over.
Once defined, a course definition is safe for replication and further more instances can be created. So a course definition is portable across various instances and each starting on a new date. So we have in the drop-down different pilot workshops and one can be chosen and all the instances already created will be shown in a tabular form. Whenever we want to add any new instance, we'll click on the add instance button and we'll be able to do that. Now, if we need to modify any instance, we'll just click on that instance. It'll take us to the managing instances page. We also have managing announcements feature where the principal course delivery manager can choose to make that announcement visible to the public or not. Coming to the program schedule, the principal course delivery manager is able to create program schedules for the face-to-face sessions via two mechanisms. One is through the software means and the other one is by an Excel upload. The principal course delivery manager can also view the schedule and can manipulate by updating and deleting feature. The admin can also view the configuration tables, cities and institute heads and can manage them. Thank you.
There is something like grading policies. What kind of grading actually it supports for?
Like we have defined the category weightages online and face to face. So the same grade. So the marks are got from
so the marks are being given manually or system will give them
from edX. We can get it directly. Rajdeep will explain that in the certificate module later on, but for the face to face, yes, we'll have to enter it manually.
And the final grade will be the absolute grading, relative grading or Gaussian analysis? How
no,
exactly
it depends it? Like we have defined your
whether you have implemented any algorithm for grading the student?
No sir. I mean it's just intervals, okay. 0, 90 to 100, 80 to.
So it is absolute grading?
Yes.
Okay.
No, but the intervals can be fixed by the.
Yes, that is flexible.
Okay. Okay, thanks.
Thank you.